Hello everyone, my name is Vivek and I am from K4 Matrix. In this video, I will be showing you how to download SE2 and how to work with it. So this is the official website to download SE2. I will leave this link in the description. And here, scroll down to the binary executables part and click on the link based on the operating system you have. Click OK. Once the download is completed, go to your downloads directory and you can see the SE2 zip file. Right click and select extract to. Choose the destination and click select. So this is the SE2 directory, and this SE2_CFT is the executable file that we will be using. Now to test SE2, I have downloaded some test cases from the GitHub website. So I'll leave this link in the description for you to check it out. And these test cases will have its own mesh file in the .su2 format and a configuration file that we will execute in su2. So this is the mesh file in the .su2 format and this is the configuration file that we will execute in su2. Now I would like to tell you that Pointwise can read mesh files of all formats and we can visualize it as well. So I will show you this by opening the .su2 mesh file in Pointwise and we will see the boundary conditions that are assigned to it. So I'll go to File, Import, Grid, and I will select the mesh file, click Open. So this is the mesh file that is in the SU2 format, and to check the boundary conditions, go to CAE and select set boundary conditions. So here you can see the far field inlet, outlet, symmetry and wall boundary conditions which are assigned to this mesh. Now let us see how to use SU2. So for that, open the terminal and I will use the CD command and navigate to the directory where the configuration file resides. So for that, go to the configuration file directory, right click on the configuration file and go to properties. Here copy the path, go back to the terminal, use CD command to navigate to the directory. So if you want to check the contents in this directory, type ll and press enter. So you can see the mesh file and also the configuration file. Now we have to give complete path to the SU2 executable file and then specify the configuration file which is to be executed. So for that, I will go to the SU2 directory and right click on the SU2 executable file. I'll copy the path. I will paste it here and also I will mention the executable file, give a space, and I will mention the configuration file. So after this, just press enter and the process will start. So this will take a couple of minutes, so I'll just pause the recording. The process is over and here you can see the boundary conditions that I had shown in Pointwise. Here SU2 has performed iterations and the values that you see here are residuals from each iteration. Now SU2 will write all these residuals into a .dat file and will be placed in the directory where your configuration file resides. Now if you want the file in a different format, that is other than .dat, then you need to make changes in the configuration file. So I'll show you the .dat file. So So this is the .dat file that SE2 has written. Now let us plot the residuals in techplot. So I'll open techplot, go to file, load data, and here I will select the .dat file, select open. In the choose loader section, select techplot data loader and click OK. Here go to mapping style and choose the data that you want to plot. So I'll choose this, and I will change the x-axis variable to inner iteration. I'll close this. For a better view, press Ctrl F or go to view and select fit to full size. So this is the method to plot residuals in techplot. So this concludes our video. Stay tuned for more.